what's up, guys? So the footage you're about to see is Steve, me, my friend Laura, and her fiance Tommy in Chicago. So I was planning on vlogging the entire trip, you know, what we ate, our workout, blah, 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 and I ended up leaving my camera at the gym. Thankfully, one of our good friends lives near the gym we were working out at, and he grabbed it for me, and it was there. So it just got shipped to me today. So the footage sadly ends after leg day at Quad's gym in Chicago. So I'm gonna play that here, and I hope you enjoy the very short vlog. Where are we going, Steve? Where are we going?
Where are we going?
So I'm not gonna look at the camera because I know we are driving here, looking at my maps. What's up, YouTube? Not looking at the camera because I'm currently driving. But we are on the way to Chi-Town, Steve and I. We are going with our good friends Laura and Tommy, who we competed with. You guys saw my show day video probably, but Laura and Tommy are the two that we spent in New York together with. And we're gonna go have some fun this weekend in Chicago and get a, like, a little, what's happening in my life? Have a little getaway. I can't even talk right now. What's wrong with me? We're having a freaking getaway because apparently I need one and I can't speak. So that's what we're doing this week. We're gonna take you along the ride. I feel really awkward right now because I can't look at you guys at the camera because you're gonna yell at me for not paying attention to the road. So I'm currently looking at the road and that's what I'm gonna do. But it's gonna be a good weekend. I'm excited. Steve's studying right now. Say hello, Steve.
Look at my sacrums.
Ew! I don't think anyone wants to look at that.
That's what I'm studying.
Yeah, as you can tell, when he's in school, his mood is very dreary.
I'm not dreary.
Studying is not the best. But, what's that?
You gotta get this pay toll in him.
Alright, we'll catch you in Chi-Town, peeps. We're 30 minutes out.
Flipping off my ring finger?
We didn't even realize this was here until like...
Really?
Yeah.
I remember when I was a kid and we used to travel, I would always want to go to the pool.
To the pool. Yeah. At a hotel. I know.
Yeah.
But it's like...
It's like, wow. Now, why would we ever want to do that?
It's so cool. Like, this pulls down.
Oh.
So it can be...
Wow.
Okay, I don't know what to do.
What the hell is that?
It pulls down.
Oh.
Oh, it's a bench.
I don't know how to...
Wait, that's sick.
Yeah, how does it work? I saw someone do it.
Don't hurt yourself.
Careful, Laura.
Wait, push up. Yeah, look at this. Look
at that. Wow.
Oh. Laura, not in here.
Quads. This is nice.
I know.
Okay, it keeps going.
It
keeps
wraps
going
all the way around.
Good morning, YouTube. We made it to Chicago, and we're in the most beautiful room ever. Let's do a little tour. So we are staying at the Trump Towers. Thank you to Laura and Tommy. And it's just so beautiful. This is where Steve and I slept. But look at the view. Holy guacamole. There's the lake, the river. It's like 9 in the morning. We've just been all like hanging out, waiting for Protein Bar to open because, you know, us fit people, that's where we want to go to breakfast. So, right, Laura?
What?
We just want to go to Protein Bar.
Heck yeah.
Because we are basically the same people and that's all what we like to eat.
All we care about is food.
All we care about is food.
All
so
we focus our time and energy on.
But
and
at least, like in New York, we were so chaotic about food because we were starving, obviously. That was post-show.
Okay, we weren't starving.
We were starving for some crap food, though.
Yeah.
Like,
but now I'm starving for some, like, fruit.
I know.
Or vegetables.
Like, a week post-show, you're like, let's go crazy with the junk, but then you just get back to your normal selves, and you're like...
Now it's just more so, like, flavor. Like,
yeah.
Freshly grilled salmon.
That sounds so good. And, like, vegetables.
And, like... I think it's just like the flavor. Well, they probably cook it with butter, so that's why it tastes so good.
But you know, semi-health. That's how we like to eat, like on a regular basis. But we kind of feel like we can enjoy the city without worrying so much about food.
And
like
wine.
We did in wine. Like we did in New York. So we'll catch you at Protein Bar.
Bye.
She said she down for me.
Equipment, this much amazing equipment. It's like 3 floors, it's psycho. Favorite gym thus far. But I did forget to record hip thrusts, a superset with unweighted hip thrusts, and then barbell curtsy lunges. That's what I forgot to record. So we're supersetting. What you just saw was pull throughs with a squat. And then we're pairing that with banded abductors and then reverse hypers. Like Laura's doing. Chew. Okay.
Are you recording?
This is a sick background.
Oh my gosh.
This is a sick background.
I hope you enjoyed that vlog, but I am now going to show you something that has helped my lower back pain tremendously. If you're new to my channel, you don't know that I struggle with back pain, and I got an MRI last week. Thankfully, nothing, I didn't have any slipped discs or herniated discs or anything of that nature. So it was musculoskeletal, which is a good thing. So anyways, I had a friend come last week and he's very, very good at mobility movements. He showed me some movements for my hips and we realized that, one hip is compensating for the other hip and they're just very, very tight. So he showed me some exercises to do, like stretches to do for before my lifts and after my lifts. And I've been doing them for the past week. My low back, guys, feels so much better. I am still getting adjusted and I'm still getting a massage with my very knowledgeable massage therapist, but my back feels a lot better. So if you're struggling with back pain and if it's musculoskeletal, try going through these hip mobility movements I'm about to show you before your leg days. The ones I'm about to show you are dynamic stretches. So dynamic is great for before your workouts. Dynamic is going into a stretch, but not holding that stretch. Kind of doing like a movement while stretching, because if you do a static hold for a stretch, you can end up injuring yourself during your lift. So static stretches are for post-workout. Dynamic stretches are for pre-workout. So I'm about to show you all the things that I did that I have been doing pre-workout, and I could be doing a lot more, but right now that is the perfect amount of time for me to spend on my hips and mobility pre-leg day. Here we go. All right, starting off with the first movement, you want to lay on your back, and then you want to go ahead and bend your knee, bring your foot out. Make sure that you are trying to aim for a 90 degree angle, and then move your leg back and forth to target that hip. You want to make sure that your hip bones are down to the ground. Try and get there as best as you can, but that's what you're aiming for. Then you're gonna go into hip circles. You want to really feel that stretch, so really bring that knee up towards your chest and drive it into the ground with your hand. It's going to hurt, but I promise you're gonna feel a ton better afterwards. You then wanna get into a pigeon pose. You wanna make sure that the leg that you're on, so this would be my right leg, is 90 degrees, and then you're gonna wanna rock back and forth, really rotating that hip to get right on top of that right leg. You're gonna wanna do this both sides at least 10 times. Go ahead and try and do all of these exercises 10 times. Then you're gonna go into leg swings. Be sure you're holding on to something in front of you so that you can really let loose on that movement. You want to make sure that you are going full range of motion there. And then with these, go ahead and use that stretch in the hamstring and hips, but obviously don't hold it there for too long, because you don't want to do any static stretching. The next one is going to be your butterfly position. Work one hip at a time, so do your left for 10 and then right for 10, and then you're going to want to do the center for 10. Make sure that your heels are as close to your body as you can get them, and really drive those hips down. You're going to get a really great stretch in the hips in that. And then the last one, you should be nice and warmed up to get into a squat position. Be sure to use your hips to help drive your knees back. This last one is a very deep side lunge. You want to work your way down towards the floor, and eventually bringing your toes all the way up towards the ceiling. You want to really get a good stretch in your hips and make sure your knees aren't caving in. And you do this by using your hips to force those knees outward. Okay, so the stretches that I showed you are perfect for pre-workout. And lastly, what I want you guys to do right before bed at night and post-workout is a couple of those stretches, but hold them. Hold them, it's gonna hurt. Hip stretches are not fun, but I promise you, your body will love you. Absolutely love you. So, I'm gonna go eat now and shower and finish up some work. If you guys have my app, Fitness by T, you'll be happy to know that I just finished up all of the videos for the nutrition content. And I'm so excited. You guys are gonna love it. And I may also have the option to purchase macro adjustments like twice a month or once a month or something along those lines, but don't hold me to it because I don't know yet, but I'm excited because we finished. Anyways, we love you guys, even though Zoe is not paying attention. She told me she loves you guys, so you guys should feel special because she normally doesn't love a lot of people besides me. So we love you, and I'll see you in the next one.